Hello viewers, welcome to the session on integrated farming system. Myself Dr. Shahaji Funder, working as an assistant director here in Center for Agri-Allied Extension Management at Manage. Today we will see about the integrated farming system. What is the integrated farming system? What is this the basic concept of this integrated farming system? Similarly, why this integrated farming system is needed? Moreover, what are the objective of this integrated farming system, or IFS we can say, and what are the different elements that is connected with this integrated farming system? Similarly, what are the major components, as a major component, or we can say as a main component or allied component for this integrated farming system? And also, what are the different factors that are affecting the kind of or type of integrated farming system? Then again, we will also see what are the different types of integrated farming system which has been recommended by different ICAR organization, and this successful model today we will see. Moreover, we will also see the economic part of the integrated farming system, mainly what are the economic gain in terms of, we can say, the output in production, productivity of different these agriculture and allied sector commodities. Moreover, what are the different advantages and limitations that needs to be studied as far as this integrated farming system is referred? And finally, we'll see what are the different thrust areas that need to be addressed for successful integrated farming system. So let me start with very brief introduction that all we know that the Indian economy is predominantly an agrarian economy. And after independence, India got ability to produce 5 times more food grain, 9 times more horticulture crops, 9.5 times milk, and moreover, the 12 times more fish production per year. However, the declining trend in land holding size poses a serious challenge to the sustainability and profitability of the farming. Cultivation of cereal and pulses alone in diminished land holding size may not be or neither providing sufficient employment nor remunerative to family income to the farmers. Further, the byproduct produced in some kind of farming system is being burned and not recycling, especially a crop residue. If we see the integrated farming system in this particular scenario, I think this particular integrated farming system approach will be a very much valuable in addressing all those issues, that is the diminishing land holding size and the production and productivity. So basically, what is integrated farming system? It is a system which comprises interrelated set of enterprises with crop activity as a base. So what are that interrelated activity? Definitely that interrelated activity related to the crop will be from livestock enterprises, will be from fishery, will be from horticulture, will be from sericulture, or maybe sometimes this interrelated activity may be some off-farm activity. So it is a system which comprises interrelated set of enterprises with crop activity as a base, provides way to recycle product and waste from one component as an input for another component of the system, along with reducing cost of cultivation and improving production or income, sustaining inherent characteristic or inherent characters of the natural resources. So let me come to the concept of integrated farming system. This is an arrangement of recycling of products, byproducts, waste, refuse of one enterprise as an input to the another linked enterprise, which offer profuse employment, regular production and income, besides reducing production risk, cost of cultivation through optimal use of natural resources and internal resource recycling by effective utilization of the family labor. So in all total, we can say that this is the effective utilization of the all the resources that the farmers have, and this is only possible through this integrated farming system. So coming to the why particularly this integrated farming system is needed. The first and foremost reason for the need of this IFS, that is reducing the risk of abiotic and biotic stresses. The second one we can say, the reducing high input cost for meeting and rising demand of food, feed and fiber. Moreover, through integrated farming system, we can meet the increased demand for soil nutrient, which ultimately demand for the higher production and productivity. Moreover, this integrated farming system will also help to meet the increased nutritional requirement of the family, because here we are taking different enterprises, or we can say set of enterprises, which comprises of some of the enterprises from the crop based, some of the enterprises we can say from horticulture side, some of the enterprises from livestock as well as the fishery. So by the integrated farming system, we can increase the demand for this nutritional requirement. Moreover, the nutritional security we can achieve through this integrated farming system. Then definitely the ultimate aim of this integrated farming system is to increase the farm income and also to meet the increased demand in employment and standard of living and sustainability. Now we will see what are the different objectives of integrated farming system. The first and foremost objective of integrated farming system is to identify existing farming system in specific area and assess their relative viability. There are so many examples of integrated farming system. So that integrated farming systems, or we can say there are different types of integrated farming system that can be suitable to the different farming system. And so the first and foremost objective of this integrated farming system is to identify existing farming system in a specific area and assess their relative viability. Then to formulate IFS model involving main and allied enterprises of different farming situation. This is the second objective of integrated farming system. Then to ensure optimum utilization and conservation of available resources. Similarly, to maintain sustainable production system without damaging resources and environment. Through this integrated farming system, we can achieve overall profitability of a farmhouse. Moreover, through this integrated farming system, we can utilize the resources at their optimum level. Then we can also promote multiple cropping to sustain land productivity, and also there is one of the major objective we can say to promote natural ecosystem services. We can preserve the natural fertility of the soil, which will ultimately result into increase in the production. Moreover, by adopting the integrated farming system, we can efficiently utilize the new innovation of cluster approaches, and also it will be helped to explore the market linkages. Then to maintain and improve diverse environment on the farm household premises, moreover to control pollution and maintain the environmental quality, which is again more important in view of the climate change, and also to establish different off-farm enterprises. This is one of the objective of integrated farming system. Finally, we can say nowadays we are seeing that many of the farmer, they are withdrawing from the farming. So, and the major reason is that nowadays farming is not remunerative. So integrated farming system, one of the objective of this particular IFS, we can say we can arrest this mass withdrawal of farmers or people through farming or from farming. Now we will see that what are the different elements of farming system, or what are the different elements of integrated farming system. So watershed, farm pond, biopesticides, biofertilizer, biogas, then solar energy utilization unit, vermicomposting unit, livestock and allied units, green leaf manuring unit or plant we can say, and agroforestry unit. Moreover, the rainwater harvesting unit also is one of the important element of integrated farming system. Let me come to the what are the components. Integrated farming system consists of mainly two components. One that is a major component and the other is allied component. The major component consists of a soil, definitely, then water, crops, livestock and labor. So these are the major components of the IFS or integrated farming system. In allied component, we can enlist all these allied activity including crop husbandry, horticulture, agroforestry unit, livestock, aquaculture, apiculture, sericulture, even mushroom cultivation and biogas plant. So these are the main component. We are integrating this allied component to the main component. That is how we are achieving the integrated farming system. If we see, there are some different factors that decides the type of integrated farming system that needs to be adopted or that needs to be disseminated. So there are different factors such as a physical factor, economic factor, social factor, environmental factor, and also as per the objective, we can suggest the different type of integrated farming system. Similarly, the prevalence of pest and prevalence of the problem of wild boar and monkeys, that also sometimes decides the type of integrated farming system. In physical factor, climate and soil along with the topography is one of the major component that needs to be seen before adoption or before dissemination of this integrated farming system. Then in economic factor, particularly the marketing, cost, labor availability, capital, land value and consumer demand also needs to be taken into consideration while taking this integrated farming system. In social factor, of course, the type of community, transport availability and marketing facility. Moreover, if we see the environmental factor, the availability of resources, components and their suitability is the major subcomponent, we can say, that needs to be seen while recommending the integrated farming system. Similarly, as per the objective that I earlier told, that the expected income from this integrated farming system, what the expected income that the farmer, they are actually expecting, that we need to see. And again, the production, minimizing the cost and output product desired. So all these factors, they are deciding the type of integrated farming system that needs to be taken by the farmer in different area. Then prevalence of pest, diseases and weeds and their control, these are also the crucial factor to take the kind of enterprise that needs to be taken in particular area. Now we will see the different type of integrated farming system. There are several types of integrated farming system. Particularly, if we enlist that, then crop livestock farming system, crop livestock fishery farming system, crop livestock poultry fishery farming system, even crop fishery poultry farming system. Similarly, the crop poultry fishery mushroom farming system, crop livestock fishery vermicomposting farming system, and likewise the crop livestock and likewise the crop livestock forestry farming system, agri silvi horticultural system, agri horti silvi pastoral system, home garden agroforestry system. The major aim of all these integrated farming system, this combining the allied sector enterprises into the main or crop enterprise. So there will be optimum use of land, labor and resources, whatever the farmers. Now we will see different popular enterprises linked to various agroecosystem. There are three different agroecosystem, that is dryland agroecosystem, garden land agroecosystem and wetland agroecosystem. So if we see, the dairy and poultry are suitable to all these three agri ecosystem. While if we see the mushroom and apiary, these particular two enterprises, they are mainly suitable to the garden land agro ecosystem and wetland agro ecosystem. While if we see the agro ecosystem specific enterprises, then dryland agro ecosystem, we can very well take the goat and sheep, agroforestry, farm pond, grass and fodder trees, plus lamb rearing. So these particular enterprises, they are linked to the dryland agro ecosystem. If we see the exclusive enterprises for the garden land agro ecosystem, then piggery and sericulture are the most suitable enterprises for the garden land agro ecosystem. While there are some enterprises that is exclusively suitable to the wetland agro ecosystem, and that enterprises are fishery and duckery. Now we will see the some different successful model of integrated farming system that has been recommended by the Indian Council of Agriculture Research and also some of the state agriculture university. Here, the one integrated farming system model that has been recommended by the Annamalai University, Tamil Nadu, combining the crop component and livestock component. In crop component particularly, they have recommended sunflower, maize, cowpea, green gram along with the crossbred cows as a livestock component or allied component, we can say. Then in crop component again, they have recommended fodder crop, BN grass or hedge lucerne, and in livestock component particularly the Telicheri goats, that is one of the goat breed they have recommended along with this crop component. The third recommendation the university have given, that is related to the horticulture crop, that is this bhendi, chili, bhendi, and this can be very well combined to the gunia fowl, that is again one of the poultry variety. Then the other model that Annamalai University they have recommended regarding to crop, livestock and fishery. In crop particularly, they have recommended rice, and in livestock they have recommended the combination of poultry as well as a local variety of fish they have recommended as an integrated farming system. Now we'll see the different model that ICR organization they have recommended for the northeast hill zone, combining all these crop, horticulture, livestock and fishery components that has been recommended for northeast hill zone that are in crop. Particularly they have recommended up highland paddy or maize. Then in horticulture they have recommended lychee, guava and papaya, as well as for the livestock they have recommended either dairy cattle, pig, poultry, duck or rabbit. And in fishery, particularly three varieties of fish they have recommended, that is what we called as a Indian common carp, and that is rohu, katla and mrigal. Then the second model that ICR Northeast Hill Mizoram Center they have recommended for this region, combining crop, horticulture, silvi plant and pastoral. In crop again the maize and soybean they have recommended along with the banana as a horticulture crop, then tick as a silvi plant, and finally the Congo signal or guinea grass as a pastoral. So these are the two models that has been recommended by the ICR institution for this northeast hill zone. Now we will see what is the expected outcome or what is the economics of this integrated farming system. Here if we see what will be the difference in the productivity, it has been seen that the productivity gain will be 2 to 3 times in integrated farming system. So similarly if we see the net return from this gain, that will be again 3 to 5 times we will get from this integrated farming system, and that to be with the saving of 40 to 50% of the resources. Moreover, if we see the average regular net daily income that can be earned through integrated farming system, so researchers have shown that nearly rupees 800 per household per hectare income that can be earned through integrated farming system. Then along with the increase in income, there is additional employment generation also. It has been seen that nearly 70 to 80% additional employment that can be generated through this integrated farming system approach. Then we can also, it is a environmental friendly practice, because with this particular practice we can reduce the greenhouse gases emission up to 50%, and similarly we can enhance the household nutritional security up to 100%, along with some of the researchers they have claimed that this can be a powerful tool for women empowerment, as it has seen that nearly 50% improvement have been seen through this integrated farming system as far as the women empowerment is concerned. Now we will see the different advantages of integrated farming system. The first and foremost advantage of integrated farming system is regular income and year-round employment. Then there will be a food and nutritional security by following this IFS approach. Then eco-recycle of agriculture residue, byproduct and waste. Moreover, there will be a soil improvement for sustainable agriculture by following this integrated farming system approach. Then minimization of pollution hazard. Similarly, improvement of microclimate and soil microflora. And likewise, through this integrated farming system, we can conserve the natural resources. Moreover, there is a possibility to minimize the risk of failures in productivity by following this integrated farming system, because one or other enterprise will fulfill the gap or reduction in the productivity if there will be some natural calamity or there will be some drop in yield of one or other enterprise. Then we'll see what are the limitations of this integrated farming system. We have seen different advantages, we have seen the different agroclimatic conditions and the type of enterprise, type of integrated farming system that has been recommended, but why this is not so popular? And there are some reasons because of that integrated farming system is not that much popular or that not much adopted by the farmers. The main limitation is lack of awareness regarding integrated farming system. People are not so much aware about. Moreover, there is non-availability of varied successful integrated farming system models. Though we have seen that there are few models that has been recommended by the ICAR organization and also the State Agriculture University, but by and large we can see that there is a non-availability of varied successful integrated farming system model. So again, there is a lack of credit facility at easy and reasonable interest rate to take newer enterprise, to combine the different enterprise. Definitely there is some kind of capital investment is needed. Then non-availability of insured marketing facility for perishable commodity. This is, we can understand that almost all agricultural commodities and allied sector commodities, they are perishable, and instant marketing facility is one of the major important prerequisite to follow not only agriculture but the integrated farming system also. Then lack of infrastructure for processing and storage facility. Then lack of timely availability of inputs for a new enterprise in IFS model. Moreover, lack of marketing for product produced in low quantities for a new enterprise, including in IFS or integrated farming system. Then lack of knowledge or education, we can say, among the farming community, especially for a rural youth in new enterprises of the integrated farming system. So these are the some of the limitations because of that integrated farming system is not much adopted in or across the country. Then what are the further thrust areas that need to be addressed in order to adopt the integrated farming system? There is a need to create database on integrated farming system. As on today, the documentation of different successful integration or integrated farming system model is not enough. Therefore, the four most important thing that there is need to create a database of all these integrated farming system with respect to the type of integrated farming system, infrastructure needed, economics sustainability, as well as economic sustainability under the different farming situation. Then there is need to develop a research module of integrated farming system under different holding sizes with economically and socially viable and acceptable system. Moreover, there is need of assessment and refinement of the technologies developed at research station suitable to the field. Again, then the further we can say, there is need for contingent planning to counteract weather and climatic threats under different farming situation. And finally, there is a need of education of rural youth, particularly in ICT and different ICT apps for creating market linkage and remunerative farm incomes. Now, let me conclude this integrated farming system. Sustainable development is the only way to promote rational utilization of resources and environmental protection without hampering economic growth. Integrated farming system in this regard hold a special position, as in this system nothing is wasted, byproduct of one enterprise become input for another linked enterprises. India has a considerable livestock and crop waste, and IFS is a promising approach for increasing overall productivity and profitability through recycling of farm waste and byproduct through efficient utilization of available resources. About 95% of input requirement of the system is self-sustained through resource recycling. As the number of enterprises increases, profit margin also increases. off-farm enterprises linked, not linked to the enterprises can also be included. It could be further generate employment opportunity of the farming community round the year and provide better economic and nutritional security. This can go long way to uplift the rural life through to increase farm income. It is evident that the profit margin varied with different ecosystem under the irrigated and rain-fed conditions. Moreover, it is also depend on the management skill and socio-economic condition. Farmers who have sufficient land and other resources can prefer integration of different horticultural crop such as a fruit, vegetable and floriculture as an additional enterprise along with the prevailing one. Whereas a marginal farmer or landless farmer living in a fruit orchid area, he can undertake the apiary and mushroom into their existing farming system. Moreover, while the farmer having sufficient irrigation facility or living in low-lying river bed areas can choose fishery as an additional enterprise. Similarly, the farmer within the vicinity of town and cities can grow vegetable, green fodder and other requirement such as a flower and green leaf garlands, banana leaves, small plant for festivals as per the market demand and availability. So this is a brief about the integrated farming system. Definitely the extension worker and the agriculture officer, agriculture allied officer, they have support, they have taken this particular initiative, and so the farming community will be benefited. Thank you.